Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Myths of Moonrise on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Myths of Moonrise and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Myths of Moonrise. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to get started we need to launch our main internet browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type that URL, because I provided the link in the video description in the first main comment. We ended up there on the internet site of Usitility, at which we include a meticulous explanation on how to download and install Myths of Moonrise on computer. We search down a little bit and press on the download game on PC button. After we click on this link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game Myths of Moonrise on PC. It is now obvious that we get several advantages of running the emulator. So we are ready to proceed to download the Myths of Moonrise by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the system. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installation software is very simple to use. It includes two possibilities, install, and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path really does. We merely simply click on it. And therefore we note that we have now here the path in which the emulator can be placed. If we are planning to modify this directory we are required to click on this browse button, therefore we pick another directory and install the emulator where we choose. I will leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I simply click install. Fantastic. The setup begins and it's going to progress along with the download of all these megabytes that are shown on that screen. The time you download it, it could possibly be a little bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate will go faster or at a lower speed, determined by your connection and depending on the speed capacity of the emulator servers. Immediately they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be launched immediately. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar which will fill up then when it has reached the end, the emulator will be started for the very first time. Indeed, the emulator was already launched, here for the very first time. Before we keep going, as you can see now, it made two app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the only one we are focused on. The moment we desire to operate Myths of Moonrise on our PC, we twice click this software icon and therefore start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we perform the following step, which is actually a must-have, and which is to visit the Google Play Store. And we are going to simply click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is started. Right here we must log on. So now as soon as we are right here, we must absolutely conduct this next step which is absolutely mandatory. Therefore we simply click on, sign in. Presently it shows, checking info. It may in some cases get stopped at checking info, additionally it fails to move ahead. In this case, you could try to connect to your account after a number of hours and it will surely usually be repaired. At this time we're going to insert our email and password. The email address really needs to be a Gmail email and its associated password. For instance, you could use the same exact email address you use right now in your YouTube account. So that I will enter my info and I'll return when I have completed it. Voila! Details inserted. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We will agree to them all simply by hitting, I agree. Following that, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it selected and this will produce a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We click accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched automatically and immediately. To set up the video game, we would need to visit the emulator desktop by double-clicking on that icon indicated green-colored. At present that we are watching the desktop of this Android emulator, we can see that we have now there the install video game button. we click or double-click on that button. Listed here we have got the video game. Let's quickly mouse-click right here on the install choice that I am highlighting now in green color. That click will commence the setup. At this time it is going to download on your laptop or computer and set up the video game. It might take a bit of time or it might possibly be almost immediate. This all is going to depend on our internet connection. This has just finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing this particular option I'm showing in green, if you want to run Myths of Moonrise for the first time. You are now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to simply click the new Myths of Moonrise icon which was generated. Your video game is launched for the very first time. Here we end up with it. I am able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the volume level of this emulator. This is right here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This way we don't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the max, we should activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is actually the first one. We simply click on that app icon which I'm mentioning in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, coming with one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Granted that we would like to have fun with the app using all the screen, we mouse click on that app icon. And we'd at present be experiencing the gameplay in 100% screen function. To leave the full screen functionality, push the F11 key. And additionally we would probably at present end up being in standard display setting. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate to you the keys mapping and that is definitely surprisingly exciting. This step we may be capable to play the video game much more easily. The first task is to mouse click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will be able to get the appropriate setups. I can let the default configuration, though if you prefer to modify this, you can easily do it now without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is presented in the incorrect language, for example, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to place it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus there inside of various other configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We are able to opt for the language we like, German, Japanese, and so on. As soon as the language is selected, we should save, the emulator would restart, as well as the Android game, the next time we start it, will as well be in the opted for language. So now, there's another element that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get an email indicating that a different machine has been linked to this Google account. It will certainly question us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we ought not be troubled, as the emulator is simulating in Google Android electronic device. So you can find which electronic device is currently being emulated. We visit right here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And there we realize that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that video tutorial. I hope that you appreciated it, especially that you found it interesting. In that case, offer it a pleasant like, subscribe to our channel, and I will be happy to answer your comments, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment field down below. You could also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams every once in a while, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Check out any of these training videos that are appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the following video game videos. Bye.